My daughter is going to set up the gear stick in neutral. Go ahead.
I'm going to show you how the beach is in a few minutes. So for now, let's enjoy the dance. This is Dominican bachata. Check that out. Oh la la.
Welcome to the first beach in Barahona. We just got to El Quemaito. Can you imagine a car that goes up only one slope without any help? In this mysterious place of the Dominican Republic, vehicles go uphill when instead they go downhill. Here we're gonna show you what I already explained. My daughter is going to set up the gear stick in neutral. Go ahead. As soon as she does that, she's not stepping on the brake and the vehicle is moving backward. Something that has no explanation, but it's only happening here. Brakes, please. Now she stepped on the brake. Park and she parked and the vehicle stopped. Again, this only happens here in the south of the Dominican Republic, Polo Town in Barahona. Welcome to Barahona province, one of the most beautiful provinces of the Dominican Republic. We get to show you a little bit, anything you need to know about the province Pearl of the South. So join me and let's go and see what Barahona has to show the world. Let's go. Barahona province was founded in 1802 by the Haitian general Toussaint de Louverture. It has an area of 1700 square kilometers and a population of 226,000 inhabitants. Its economy is based mainly on agriculture activities, especially the cultivation of sugarcane. And it has one of the four refineries of sugarcane still left in the Dominican Republic, built in the year 1918. Another very important crop for the province is bananas. It is said that the best bananas in the country grow in this province, especially plantain bananas. Local tourism, it's one of the important activities for the province as well. The typical dish is the seafood, especially fried seafood. If you're a surfer, here we have a special beach for you. It is Paradiso Beach in Barahona province. Now, let's see what this province has to offer in its main touristic attraction. Welcome to the first beach in Barahona. We just got to El Quemaito. Something special I want to show you all about this beach. Wait for it. If you see over there, the seawall. All right, so the seawalls never come to the shore. This is a national seawall that this beach has, something that makes it unique. So the family can come here and they'll have a risk that the kids in danger. Therefore, you can see there's a lot of kids over here from all over the country that come to this beach, El Quemaito. If you know the meaning of El Quemaito, it means the burning, because that's how it feels like when you come here and you burn, right? So make sure when you come to this beach, you bring sunblock. Something else I want to show you about the beach, in the back over there, those are tents. You come to this beach, you come with your family, of course, you rent one of those, right? By renting, you don't have to pay, but you have to consume. What I mean by that? You buy beer, you buy seafood, whatever, and then you pay for it. So you don't have to pay money, but you have to consume, it's renting, okay? I'm going to show you what this beach has for meal next. So stay tuned and you'll see. This is the fish I was talking to you about. The name of the fish is yellowtail snapper. It comes with fried, which is plantain banana, and ketchup and salt.
Okay.
Yummy. Thank you. See you later. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the most beautiful view of the Dominican Republic. It is San Rafael Beach, top three in the country. We are heading southwest of Barahona province, and you can see the beauty over here. A color that you might not find nowhere else throughout the Dominican Republic. So stay tuned and you will see how the beach is once we get there. So here I am walking down the beach. This is a path that connects to the beach. Today, Sunday, so many people coming from everywhere. You can see the sign as a welcome to the beach, San Rafael. There's all kinds of buses, different buses from all over the country. San Rafael Beach, for me, top three in the Dominican Republic. Instead of coming to San Rafael, I recommend anybody who comes with children to go to the one at the entrance, Los Quemaditos, because over here, it's not as safe. There's so many waves. So my recommendation, go to Los Quemaditos. Now, if you come as an adult, you know, and not children, then this beach is nice. Otherwise, you'd rather go to Los Quemaditos. That is even closer to downtown Barahona. Something else that we have over here, I'm gonna show it to you afterward. Now, what I mean by not coming with the kids, it's waves. Notice the waves are rougher, and then you come with kids, not a good idea. You see, over here, it's mainly adults. And if there is any child, then they stay on the shore. They're never there to go inside as we watch the one we just went. This is San Rafael. And then, of course, the Dominican Republic, a place that has baseball as a national sport. There's kids, instead of going to the beach, playing ball. Check this out. Kids playing ball instead of going swimming because they know they're in risk if you go to the beach. Swing in the mix. It's really full. It's everybody here. Completely full. It's even fuller than the one we went. Way more people. Okay, so this is San Rafael Beach. We're gonna go to the watery instead. I'll see you later. Keep watching. Over here, uphill the beach, we got San Rafael watering, which is basically this water coming down from the mountain. The water is extremely cold. So if you don't like cold water, I don't recommend you to go and swimming there because it's going to be really, really cold. I'm gonna go jump in and see what happens. So now it's time for me to go into the water, and as soon as I step in, it feels extremely cold. There we go. Let's enjoy this river. Oh, it's so cold. Enjoy my day.
drinking a presidente. There's nothing better than drinking a presidente when you are in a cold water temperature. And this one hits me up. Cheers to you all. See you next place we go. Goodbye.
Guys, we just got to Los Patos. Los Patos is like the last place where there's a tourist here in the province of Barahona, okay? So Los basically has here a river, which is, as a matter of fact, the shortest of the Dominican Republic and the whole world, with just 1 kilometer length. You can see how it looks like here. And there's music, there's places to buy food, people drinking, and over there, music, people also dancing. So this is the river, and down the end over there, the beach. I'm going to show you how the beach is in a few minutes. So for now, let's enjoy the dance. This is Dominican bachata. Check that out. Oh la la. Isn't that beautiful? Enjoy the rhythm with Dominican dancers dancing bachata. Epa. Now I'm walking down to the beach. And here is the river mouth. The beach is over there, down the end. Almost nobody likes to come to the beach, but to the river. So behind me, where we were, where the music was, the river coming from the mountain, and down that way there, the beach. So we're gonna leave it up to here about the province of Barahona and the entertainments, the places where people usually go. Tonight, I'm going to show you how nightlife is in the province. So I'm gonna show you restaurants, how nightlife is with dancing, drinking, the ambience, etc. I'll see you later. Goodbye. Finally, driving at night in Barahona, and is how it looks like. Check this out. The name of this avenue, it's El Malecón. Malecón in Barahona. And you're going to see a lot of bars, places having fun. Look at this. Freestyle lounge, sport bars, rubble sport bars, Blue Beach. Check this out. Everybody's outside having fun on Sunday, the way it should be. Even people playing domino over there. Look at that. Bachata, bachata. This is the end of the video. Hope you like it. I'll see you in another video soon. Good night.